Garuda Purana, Chapter 09- Shri Krishna. Making a revelation to Vyas that the Almighty God manifests Himself whenever the civilization is endangered by the dominance of sinners, Lord Brahma said in Dwapar Yuga, Lord Vishnu incarnated as Shri Krishna to protect Dharma from being subjugated by Adharma, which had become all-pervasive at that time. He was born to Vasudeva and Devaki. Both his parents had been kept under captivity by Kasa, who was aware of the prophecy that he would be killed by Devaki's 8th son. In due course of time, Devaki gave birth to 7 sons, all of whom were mercilessly killed by Kasa one by one. In order to protect the life of Shri Krishna, the 8th child born to Devaki, Vasudeva exchanged him with a baby girl born to Yashoda and Nand. Vasudev had no problem in moving out of the prison as Krishna by his divine power induced all the guards to sleep. Shri Krishna, being an incarnation of Lord Vishnu, performed great feats right from his childhood. Once, Kasa sent an ogress named Putna, who tried to kill Shri Krishna by breastfeeding him. But Krishna sucked her breasts with such ferocity that Putna met an instant death. In due course of time, Shri Krishna killed many more ferocious demons like Shakatasur, Kalyanag, Dhenukasurya, and mesmerized the residents of Gokul by his divine bravery. He also performed many other divine feats like lifting Govardhan mountain and performing Ras Leela with the gopis. Seeing all his plans of killing Shri Krishna go in vain, Kasa sent him a message challenging for a duel bout with his court wrestlers named Mushtik and Chana. Shri Krishna killed both the dreaded demons without much difficulty. Ultimately, Shri Krishna climbed up the throne sitting on which Ravana had been watching the wrestling bout and pulled him down by his hair. He then punched Kasa on his chest so hard that he died an instantaneous death. Having accomplished his most important mission of killing the demon king Kasa and liberating the earth from his tyranny, Shri Krishna went on to complete his education under the tutelage of sage Sandipani. During ancient times, it was customary for a disciple to offer dakshina to his teacher as a mark of respect after his education was complete. Shri Krishna, following this tradition, gave an invaluable dakshina to his guru by bringing all his dead sons alive to earth from Yamloka. Shri Krishna was subsequently crowned as the king of Mathura, but on account of the relentless attack by Jarasandha, he had to abandon his dear city and shift his base to Dwarka. He had 8 queens, among whom Rukmini and Satyabhama were prominent. Later on, he rescued 16,100 women from the captivity of Narakasurya and married all of them. From Rukmini, he had a son named Pradyumna, who killed Shambharasur. Aniruddha was Pradyumna's son and he married Usha, daughter of Banasur. Banasura was a great devotee of Lord Shiva and was blessed with 1,000 hands. Lord Shiva came to his rescue at the time when he was battling against the might of Shri Krishna. A fierce battle was fought between both the deities, which remained inconclusive even after a long time. Lord Shiva then requested Shri Krishna to spare Banasura's life, to which he agreed, albeit partially. Shri Krishna severed all the hands of Banasur barring 2. Finally, after accomplishing his mission of liberating the earth from the darkness of sin, Shri Krishna left for heavenly abode.